Hey guys, it's Steven and Ellie the Chihuahua here. A few of you have been asking me how I travel with Ellie in the car, so I thought in this video I would show you my setup in the car and how we travel together. Does that sound good to you? I think she wants to go to sleep. If you have a really large dog like a Labrador or a German Shepherd, you would not travel in the same way that I travel with Ellie in the car. However, for a small dog or a Chihuahua, you know, maybe this will be a little bit helpful for you. So the preparation for the car journey starts inside with her harness. I'm just gonna slip that over her legs and clip it on. It took me a really long time to get a harness that actually fit Ellie in the way that I wanted it to fit her. This harness does not go around her neck, it goes around her two front legs and it fits her perfectly. She can't wiggle out of it and it doesn't pull on her windpipe, so absolutely perfect. Perfect size. Okay, so we're gonna move to the car. So here we are in the car. This is Ellie's doggy car seat. I actually bought this online, they're really easy to come across. The reason I chose this car seat is because it's nicely lined with some soft fabric. It secures to the car really firmly with these straps. And inside there is also a little lead to clip Ellie's harness into. It's really important that you get a doggy car seat where your dog can actually be clipped into it, because if you don't, and if you were to suddenly break, your dog would go flying because there's no support for them in the car. The first time I put Ellie in this car seat, I did it really slowly and just let her get used to being in it. And I'm gonna do the same now. So Ellie is just sat in the basket. She's not moving very much, just getting used to it, having a little sniff around. This is always the most difficult part of the whole thing. And we're just gonna clip this on as if I was giving her a walk, and we're all done. You wanna just be with her for a moment, give them lots of calming cuddles and kisses. You could put the favorite toy in there, give them a treat, make them realize it's a safe space for them to be in. It's also really important that your dog is in the back seat as opposed to the front seat, because if your car's like mine, I have airbags in the front seat, and if I was to crash the car and this was in the front seat, the airbags would hit this basket and again it could really hurt Ellie. So in the back seat she's nice and safe, nice and secure. Good to go, Ellie. Good to go. And that's it, guys. Really simple and easy. We can take her harness off now. Good girl. You're a really good girl. I hope that gave you a little bit of inspiration as to a little doggy basket that you could buy your small dog. And just remember to keep them in the back seat and not the front seat, because you don't want them to get hurt by those airbags. And make sure you don't let them have free rein of the car. They do need to be secure. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a like. Make sure you hit the subscribe button and notification bell so you know when we're going to be uploading videos again. We'll see you soon. Say bye, Ellie. Bye. Goodbye.